Assalamu alaikum students, today we are going to discuss about the asexual reproduction in Pythium. Actually it is a type of fungi. So when we talk about the asexual reproduction, then there are three methods through which asexual reproduction in Pythium take place. So first method of the asexual reproduction is zoospore formation. Second method is known as conidia formation, and the third method is aplanospore formation. Or it is also known as chlamydospore formation. So these are three methods through which asexual reproduction in the Pythium take place. So firstly, we will try to discuss about the first method, which is known as zoospore formation. So firstly, we can write here zoospores formation. So when we talk about these zoospores, actually these zoospores are kidney shaped. It means the shape of zoospore is like kidney, and if we talk about the kidney shape, so kidney is like this. Actually this is the shape of kidney. So when we talk about the shape of kidney, so there are two faces. One is a this face or a side which have a small depression, and this one is a side where it is a smooth and no depression. So this side is known as concave side. And this bulged portion is known as convex side. It means the kidney has two sides. And if the zoospore is kidney shaped, then it have two flagella, and these flagella are present on the concave side. So that's why you can write here zoospores are kidney shaped and two flagella are present at zoospores at the concave side. So actually this is a zoospore which is produced inside a structure, and a structure which produce these zoospore. Actually this is a zoospore. This one is a flagellum, and two flagella are present, and these zoospores are produced in a structure which is known as sporangia. It means the structure which is involved in the formation of such type of spores, which are known as zoospore, such structure is known as sporangia. So how the sporangia are involved in the formation of zoospore? Actually sporangia are globose or a globe-like. Globose mean globe-like or a round. So how these sporangia look like? For example, this one is a body of fungus, and this one is a zoosporangia or a sporangia. At the tip of sporangia, another bulged portion is present, outgrowth is present, and this outgrowth is known as papilla. And this one is fungal body. This portion is known as sporangia, at the tip of sporangia, another structure is present, and this structure is known as papilla. And all the zoospores are produced in this structure, and this structure is known as papilla. So how the zoospores are produced in the zoosporangia? Actually, the papilla is the part of zoosporangia. This is not another structure. This is actually a part of the sporangia which is present at the top of sporangia, which is known as papilla. So how this is involved in the formation of zoospore? Actually, this is the body, this is a sporangia, and this one is a papilla. A vesicle, membranous vesicle, is formed inside this papilla like this. This one is a membranous vesicle. And inside the membranous vesicle, all the nuclei as well as protoplast is present. And the protoplast of this papilla break into many pieces. So actually, these are the pieces of protoplast. These are the pieces of protoplast. And each piece of protoplast contains a single nucleus like this. Now, these are the fragments of the protoplast containing a single nucleus. And after the some time, these nuclei surrounding a nucleus will be converted into zoospore. So actually, this one is a body of fungus. Body of fungus. This one is sporangia. Sporangia. It is a part of sporangia which is known as papilla. And this is a membranous vesicle. Membranous vesicle. But inside the membranous vesicle, these are the fragments of protoplast with nuclei. So we can write here, this one is a fragment of protoplast with nucleus, and all these will convert into zoospore. So how these will convert into zoospore? Actually, this is a body, this one is a zoosporangia, and this one is a papilla, and inside these nuclei with protoplast change their shape and become a zoospore like this. These are actually zoospore. These are kidney shaped. Now these are actually the flagellated zoospore which are present in the sporangia. Actually, it is the wall of sporangia and it is the wall of papilla. Actually, the papilla is the part of sporangia, but this whole structure is known as sporangia. Upper portion of sporangia is known as papilla. So when these will mature, then they will come out. For example, these are the zoospores which are kidney shaped, and these are biflagellated. These are kidney shaped biflagellated zoospores. These are kidney shaped biflagellated zoospores. Now these zoospores are produced. So we can write here, these all are zoospores, and these zoospores are produced in the papilla. Papilla is present at the tip of the sporangia, and actually the papilla is a part of sporangia. So now these zoospores are produced. These zoospores may germinate to produce a new mycelium or a new fungal body. So now we are going to discuss about the second method, which is known as conidia formation actually. So the second method is known as conidia formation. Conidia formation. Actually, when The sporangia will detach from the body of a fungus during the unfavorable condition, then it becomes conidiosporangia. For example, this one is a sporangia, but conditions are unfavorable, then this sporangia will detach. When this sporangia will detach from the parent body of a fungus, it become conidiosporangia. It is known as conidiosporangia. When it become conidiosporangia, then the spore inside the conidiosporangia are known as conidiospores. Conidiospores. So we can write here, conidiosporangia contain conidiospores. Conidiospores. And these conidiospores, when the favorable condition will come, then these conidiospores will germinate to produce a new fungal body. So now we are going to discuss about, at the last, it is the aplanospore formation, or also known as chlamydospore formation. So we can write here, chlamydospore formation. Chlamydospore formation is so simple. These chlamydospores are produced actually same like conidia formation or a conidiospore formation. But when these conidiospores or a chlamydospore formation, which are also known as aplanospores, these are also known as aplanospores. These produce same like the conidia formation. So, but when they will germinate, they will produce a long hyphae. After the germination, it means the germination of chlamydospores, they give rise long hyphae.